Hi. Lately I've been thinking about the choices I have made and doubt the life I've chosen for myself. I wonder how it would pan out if I stuck to the status quo and stayed in England. Never know, but when I see my friends, I see them with this golden glow.
Guys, it is after work. I'm about to get ready to record with Ishika. Now that I'm working a full-time job, the only time that I can record for the pod is after work. So I'm gonna get ready right now, do my makeup so I don't look dead. I think I'm gonna wear a chill outfit while I'm recording because I'm not really feeling dressing up today. We're gonna do a really simple makeup routine. I just wanted to show you guys my favorite foundation and then we'll do a time lapse. So I've been using the Tarte Amazonian Clay Foundation in the color Tandy Golden and it is the best thing ever. I highly recommend you get it. It doesn't feel heavy. It lasts all day. This with the Laura Mercier setting powder. Chef's kiss. So good. Such a good combination. Let's do a time lapse. So I decided to wear a very chill outfit for recording today. I am so tired, but we just gotta do what we gotta do. I chugged my matcha and it kind of woke me up.
I usually wear something a little bit more all out, but today just no. I am wearing the sweat set from Set Active. They have a bunch of different colors. Their colors are very just like one time only, but this is from last year, I feel like, and I got in the color slate. I have my Amazon hoops in and I'm gonna pop up some more jewelry just so it looks like I'm put together. Also, this is where we record. So basically I have this mirror going on and it looks really pretty here, but for me and Ishika to both record, I put my chair here and then I also get my desk chair and I put it over there. My room is not very big, so I kind of just have to move things around just so it works.
It looks so artsy, but this is what I do. I take the big mirror and I move it around. And then after I have this like space over here, I take my desk chair, which isn't the most comfy thing, but it fits in the spot. And then to make it comfy, I take this like fuzzy blanket that I keep on my bed that I don't really use, but I keep it for show. And then I throw it on. Another thing that I also do is I have this little like table. Like, oh my God, it's like wrapped in wires. Get away, get away. I'm just gonna put it right here and then I grab my laptop. And at the moment we only have one mic working, so we're just using one mic, which kind of sucks. The audio is not the best, but it's still pretty good. I'm gonna double check to see if the other mic works today, but if not, then it's just gonna be this one. So yeah, that is the little podcast setup. I just stick the mic on the table, this little table right here, and that's how we record. Ish and I just finished the fourth episode of the podcast. I meant to film in the beginning, but I completely forgot, so. And we're making some TikToks as well. Yes. So yeah, I have went for a chill vibe today because I had a full work day, but Ishika looks really cute, so.
Because I was like, I had a lazy day, so I was like, let me put on some jeans to feel
good.
Yeah, to feel good.
Okay, we're gonna make the TikToks. Bye. So it's around 8 p.m. and Ishika left, so I'm gonna remove everything that was here before. So I'm gonna bring my freaking mirror back here because this is not good.
All right, there we have it, back to normal.
Work has been a little difficult adjusting to like a 40-hour work week compared to me not working that much. I mean, I do work a lot, but I feel like when I'm doing social media, I kind of work on my own time, so it's totally different. So in general, this was just a really big change. Definitely getting used to all of that and everything like that. It's been a little difficult, but it's only been a week, so obviously it's gonna be a little difficult in the beginning, but it is what it is. Anyways, I need you guys to look at the sky because it's so pretty. Oh my God, look at it. Beautiful. And these are the little things that make me really happy in the day. I'm bringing this.
I got something smooth in my cup, yeah. I drops when they go take a puff, yeah. I don't think you about to come and bluff, huh? I don't think I went and had enough.
And I ain't found euphoria. Hold my hand on the man when she pour it up. Getting bands be the plan when we growing up. Understand, I'ma stand when
so,
it comes
you guys
to
probably saw my... Oh, the lighting is absolutely horrendous down here, but... You guys probably saw me go through my whole morning this morning. I went on a hike, walked like 5.5 miles, ate some breakfast, and now I need to like edit a video and do a bunch of other things. Now that I've started working like a full-time job, my main priority is like trying to do my creative stuff on the weekends and then also after work, because like during the day I obviously cannot be doing that. So right now I'm gonna edit a video that's gonna go up on Wednesday, and yeah, I'm trying to do 2 videos a week. It's definitely very difficult for me because getting used to a 9-to-5 and also like doing a bunch of other things and also staying social and taking care of myself, it's definitely very difficult, but we're getting the hang of things, and soon enough I'll definitely get a hang of things and we'll be able to post more as much as I can. So I need to do some stuff for the pod, so I'm going to FaceTime Ishika really quickly and see if she picks up. Basically every episode of our podcast goes up Mondays, and then we usually record on Monday too, but some days we're not able to because we either have something or I just started working, so we're trying to figure out a schedule. But I'm about to make the outline, so we're kind of just trying to discuss the topic. So I'm just gonna text her about it because Ishika won't pick up my phone. I took a little break and I did my hair because I was just really not feeling myself while I was looking at the camera. Still editing a YouTube video. I need to get it up today because it's gonna go up Wednesday, and I personally just don't have time throughout the week while I'm working. So editing, still editing. It's like 4 p.m. now, like 4:15. Video is up, well, it's uploading right now, and I just have to make the thumbnail. And I really like this video. I like talked a lot about like confidence and my confidence journey, and a lot of you guys have been asking me about that. I figured I'd make a video about it, and I think it's coming out pretty good. I also need to drink a lot of water. But I use my iPad and use Procreate and make the thumbnail, and I think the video is gonna be done. And then after that, we're gonna edit the podcast and get that up, and then we're gonna clean my room and set some goals for the week. It's a very busy Sunday. Alrighty, I am back in my room and we're gonna write some goals. So I'm going to set some goals for the week with you guys, because something that I've been trying to, this is not my journal. Something that I've been trying to do lately, setting goals Sunday night for the week to make sure that everything that I wanna get done is kind of gotten done, so that I'm not stressed, so that I accomplish everything that I want to do. Yeah, it makes it so much better. So I have a little journal right here. I separate it into creative stuff, health and wellness stuff, socializing, because that is also a really important thing to me. So I'm going to start off with wellness and health related wellness. I'm going to try to work out 4 to 5 times a week and journal and read for 20 minutes a day. Another thing is meditate 2 times, because I'm trying to incorporate it back into my routine. I used to do it a while ago, like a couple of years ago, like every day, and I just can't stick to it. So 2 times a week is a good starter. Now off of wellness, and in terms of content and creative, so 2 videos a week on YouTube is the goal. I'm going to try for 1 to 2 TikToks a day. So now the content and the creative stuff is done, and the last one is, wait, that may be it. Oh, socializing, hang out with friends, FaceTime, and then that is my little goal sheet. And I'll look at that while I'm journaling every day this week, so that I can kind of like reflect on everything that I've been wanting to do and the goals that I've set for the week and making sure that I do accomplish that. And what kind of inspired me to want to, you know, write down my goals is this little segment in this book that I've been reading, and I always look back on it whenever I need the inspiration, but it's You Are a Badass by Jen Sincero. I talk about it all the time. I think literally my favorite self-improvement book. So I'm gonna read a little passage. Give yourself the permission and the means to be who you are regardless of what anyone else thinks or believes is possible. Do not deny yourself the life you wanna live because you're worried you're not good enough, or that you'll be judged, or that it's too risky, because who does that benefit? No one. When you live your life doing the things that turn you on, that you're good at, that brings you joy, makes you shove stuff in people's faces and scream, check this out. You walk around so lit up that you shoot sunbeams out of your eyeballs, which automatically lights up the world around you, which is precisely why you are here, to shine your big ass ball of fire onto this world of ours, a world that literally depends upon light to survive. You are powerful, you are loved, you are surrounded by miracles. Believe, really believe, that what you desire is here and available to you, and you can have it all. And that kind of really inspired me to want to set goals for the week. And until I move out, I don't want to just sit around and wait until I do. I want to make action right now. And to do that, I need to set little goals for myself. And, you know, as much as a lot of things like creativity and stuff like that can't be forced, you do need the motivation to kind of push yourself to edit a video. And then once I start editing, I get in the flow. I'm going to start doing that every single week because I feel like with everything getting busy, I always believe that there is enough time in the day to do whatever you want to do. And you'll always make time when you do love something. I'm going to do a little weekly room clean out, just like a little organize. It's not as messy as it usually is. And there we have it, clean and organized. Love to see it. Woo, woo, woo. Also, I'm wearing such a simple outfit at home. I've been loving these shorts from Zara. They're like the mom shorts. I just think they're so comfortable. Although they do like stretch a lot and they get like really loose, I still really love them. And then I'm wearing this like old Urban Outfitters tee. It's literally just a crop tee and my Amazon hoops. I look crazy. I just washed my face and my skincare. Now I need to get ready because I need to leave in like 30 minutes. I'm gonna do my makeup, put on my outfit. A rush.
Okay, I am all ready for work. I just fixed my hair, put on some hoops, and I have this cute little outfit, and I'm gonna wear some nude flats with it. Both these things are from Zara. I just love these pants. I just got them, and they are just perfect. I absolutely love them. I'm gonna have to buy them in different colors just because I think they just fit so perfectly. But I need to go. I'm in a rush. I need to make myself some breakfast. And yeah.
But I guess I'll never know it, what the other book looks like.